Right about now.
All right.
You're about to be possessed.
Let's do it. Episode 18. MC Raw Face. And DJ something right, five, right. I believe. Alrighty, Ooh, almost just started playing the outro song a little early. So I made a small boo-boo in the very, very brief introduction. This is still episode 18, but it is something-something episode 6. Something-something episode 5 was back in end of May. That was episode 15. So, what do we want to talk about? Now, these ones are less the, you know, general topic or, like, you know, lately it's been mental health themed, but, like, I'd like to branch out eventually, and I don't know if that sort of stuff would fit with the topic themed episodes, or if it would be better to do it, so OBS was giving me some stupid error that, you know, it's using up too much, CPU power, and it's like, listen, I'm only using up like 30% of my CPU right now. It's nothing. But I don't know if the other topics that I like to talk about and learn about and, you know, just read about everything would be better on these episodes, or if it would be better on the general, you know, topic episodes. So I'm gonna play around with that idea a little bit and see where it takes me. I'm recording this. It's not quite halfway through the month of October. No, not October. Wow, September. And a lot of stuff has been happening, unfortunately, and fortunately. I mean, there's, for everything negative that, you know, we read about in the news, see on TV, hear about on social media, wherever, there are 5,000 more positive things that we're not seeing. And that's kind of by design, unfortunately. You know, back in the mid-2010s, let's say, because Facebook didn't become a thing until 2005, I don't think. Same year as YouTube, I think, or unless it's 2007 for YouTube, I don't know. Either way, I didn't start using either until 2008, so, you know, I was a early-ish to the game, but not, you know, a founding member or anything like that. But anyways, Facebook did a study back in the 2010s at some point that they figured out that people who were more upset, you know, angry, sad, whatever, were more likely to stay engaged longer than people who were happy. And they actually use those internal algorithms to show you more posts that potentially can upset you or that are just designed to keep you on the website or app longer. You know, it's designed to be very, very addictive. And, you know, the algorithm isn't quite as frighteningly accurate or good as TikTok's, but, you know, it's still pretty good, I would say. And it's really why I try to limit my time on there. But, you know, back to what I was saying was that recently the biggest news story has been the fall of Afghanistan, and you know, the U.S., we finished the final withdrawal process, and the last thing I heard was that allegedly a few hundred people would still be allowed to fly out of Kabul, you know, that's up to interpretation, and we'll have to see about that, but it breaks my heart to see these kind of fundamental ideologies still, you know, having such a strong foothold in the world in this time period. You know, it's either the my way or the highway thing, and it's, you know, there's a whole generation of women out there in Afghanistan that, you know, have not lived under that Taliban rule that are now going to be subjugated to policies that weren't in place since, you know, 2001. And so my, you know, my heart really goes out to them and, you know, all the other countries in the world that are also having tough times. Mozambique, notably, they were having a very, very hard time with insurgents and, you know, terrorist activities at, I want to say, their main port. They've kind of fallen off of my radar and, you know, the radar in general as of late, because the Afghanistan thing was just such a big deal. And I mean, it's not that it's not still, it's just, you know, the U.S. media has kind of backed off of that and kept going in other directions, you know. And I try my best not to pay too much attention to the news media because, you know, again, it's designed to keep us watching, you know, and always trying to find out the next thing. It wants to keep us on edge, and it's not a good way to live. You know, we shouldn't be in the dark about the world around us, and that's why I always recommend learning, reading as much as you can, and just, you know, expanding. I don't want to necessarily say it, but, you know, expanding your consciousness, because I think that's just the best way to live. But at the same time, I think I talked about, maybe last episode, I'm not sure when I talked about it, but information overload is a very, very real thing. And when we absorb too much at the same time, you know, it's not good. But you see, this is almost turning into a regular topic themed episode. You know, I could go on and on about information overload, but yeah, Afghanistan is just not in a good place right now, and I am just ashamed of the leadership right now, honestly. You know, there was a Marine, I believe he was a lieutenant colonel, I could be fucking that up right now, I forget, but he decided to speak out against the Department of Defense and Department of State's just a lack of credibility, accountability, and all these different things, you know, coming out of Afghanistan. And so far, he's been the only person fired, which I think is fucked up, because most recently, you know, as we were speeding up our exit, 13 of our service members were killed in a suicide bombing by this group out of I forget what the province's name is, but it's ISIS-K, and the K stands for the province they're from. But yeah, all these different fringe fundamental ideologies that, you know, aren't backed by any, I mean, you know, Afghanistan has a very, very long and complicated history, and I don't want to simplify it down to, you know, us and the Soviets versus them, because it started with the British, you know, back in the late 19th century, and then Britain backed India trying to invade, and, you know, back when it was still Persia and Pakistan, not, is it Pakistan? Yeah, the mountains of Pakistan, the mountain region, and Afghanistan used to be one country, and it was under the Persian Empire. But yeah, there's a lot to unpack there, and that's why I don't like politicians or anyone who blames something on one thing. You know, there's no simple answer to most things. Anyone who tells you this is that because of this or that usually has something to gain from blaming, you know, whatever it is. In World War II, Adolf Hitler blamed all of Germany's problems on the Jewish problem, the Zionists' takeover of whatever. And as far as I know, the Jewish population of the country didn't force them into signing the Treaty of Versailles. That was the I don't think they were called the Allies in World War One, but you know, the U.S., England, well, the U.K. rather, and France. You know, all the countries. Well, you know, I guess countries are kind of companies, but everyone that was opposite, you know, Germany, the Austro-Hungarian Empire, and I think they were called the Central Powers. I'm not positive. I need to brush up on my World War One history, but yeah, when someone wants to blame one thing on, blame a problem on just one cause, then you know something is up there. Because, you know, most problems at least, are multifaceted, or they just have a lot of different, you know, roots, causes, you know, that's why in science, when you're doing an experiment, you have to, account for as many variables as possible, because if you don't use a control and then you get different results and different runs of your experiment, then how are you to know that, you know, the results aren't a direct effect from something that you couldn't control happening? You know, it's very, I don't know, it's very dishonest to people to say that, you know, to I don't want to say dumb things down, but to oversimplify things to the point of, well, you know, all of this is caused by this one single issue. And it's like, okay, do you care to expand upon that? No, because, you know, they don't care about, you know, being truthful in that manner. They care about eliciting a reaction, you know. We're very emotional creatures, and logic and facts don't always come across, you know, as what we really want. And sometimes emotions win in a lot of situations. And, you know, that's just the name of the game, unfortunately. That's why if we can look internally, try to, you know, first we kind of have to name our emotions and kind of realize what we're feeling, and that, you know, our emotions don't control us, rather our thoughts and actions control them, you know, or cause them. And so when we do that, we can kind of overcome them, you know, because, you know, my anger doesn't define me, my anxiety doesn't define me, you know, whatever you want to fill in that blank with, it doesn't define you. It's just a symptom of being human. And, oh man, I'm just going to start yawning into the mic. I'm not even that tired. I mean, I am, but it's just, I went out to dinner earlier and ate a little too much, and, you know, it's that kind of like post-dinner pre-coma feeling. And goodness. Yeah, I just totally got sidetracked. I just, you know, thinking about our emotions and realizing that we are emotional creatures. We're creatures of habit too. So These are all just things to think about and consider when you're listening to someone who is telling you that, you know, these problems can be dumbed down into one or two simple answers, when you might know or might even just think about, it's more complicated than that, you know. It would be like saying, it's raining because water is falling from the clouds. That's partially true, and it's mostly true, you know, but how does the water get to the clouds once it's back on the ground? You know, otherwise, if rain if water didn't evaporate and we didn't have the whole cycle of how water and liquids work, you know, in their different states, then we would just have rising water levels, and eventually we wouldn't be able to survive because water would just, you know, cover up the land, and that'd be it. We'd get flooded out. But, you know, we have water that evaporates, goes up to the sky, and then comes back down as rain once it goes through some atmospheric pressure changes. See, that's kind of where I don't know a ton about the atmospheric stuff when it comes to meteorology. I try to open this bottle of water, I'm going to splash myself. But I know, you know, a fair bit, or essentially the basics about phase changes or phase shifts and things like that. There we go. Almost got it. Got it. And gotta rip the cap. There we go. So, I mean, even that's an area I could always learn more about. Gotta stay hydrated. I'm not sure if that's also making me want to yawn more or not, but, just gotta do deep, deep, deep inhales. And then good exhales. kind of got a little sidetracked. In other news, I think I talked about it in the last episode a lot. Been doing jiu-jitsu, you know, ever since the start of the summer. I want to say, you know, either during that time I recorded, the last something-something, or, maybe a little bit after that, I'm not really sure. Been doing it for a few months now, and, really like it, really taking a lot of good lessons from it, and just, you know, I would say that it's definitely improved, my life in a lot of ways, you know, so that's, you know, that's a very positive thing right now that's going. And I know that, you know, combat sports aren't for everyone, so I suppose I'll try to limit the metaphors and stories about it, but at the same time, it's, you know, it's important to me, so it's kind of, it's going to be a little difficult. But even though, I just got to say this about it, though. I would say it's less violent than, you know, maybe the striking arts. And at the same time, it's very flowing, you know, like the ebb and flow of things. It's, you know, when you're rolling with somebody, there's a lot of back and forth, and the more you learn and get better, the more you learn about how to move more with, you know, spending less energy and a lot of fun things like that. So, you know, I'm really excited to keep learning and keep refining and just, you know, first I got to get, you know, all the basics down and really solidify those core fundamentals. But, you know, it's a great way to learn self-defense. It's a great hobby to get into, or an activity that you just really can sink a lot of time and energy into. And, you know, it's been great so far. So that's a really good thing that I'm, enjoying right now. And then also on the positive front, gonna be buying a house here soon. Well, we're in the process of it. Gonna be closing here anytime now. I'm gonna be kind of vague about this part only because of you know, how much there is to that, but I'm really happy to be moving into that soon. And then from there, just going to keep grinding away at work, jitsu, doing this when I can. Going to try to keep, you know, pre-recording episodes and keep possibly build up a bank of them, you know. I mean, I don't want them to get too outdated, but if I can keep a few of the topic-themed episodes recorded in the vault, you know, then I can release them or even say, hey, I was planning on doing this, but here's this instead if things come up. And then I'm also going to be looking into having guests on soon. I don't know if I mentioned any of that yet. I think I might have mentioned one possible guest, but I'm not sure if that has already fallen through or not. You know, things can happen, and that's okay. So the biggest thing is we just got to keep our heads up, keep trucking along, keep trudging forward. You know, we're all in this together. And I don't want anybody to feel like they're suffering alone, you know. And I'm not trying to bring this to like a downer, negative outro or anything. Because the outro song, it does make me a little sad, I'll be honest. But mostly just because of the time period that it came out and memories of that. But I do really like both of the artists in it. And the music video was really fun to watch on MTV and VH1 back in the day when those stations still did that. Oh my gosh. Like, I swear I am tired, but I just need to, maybe it's if I just am not as hunched over and I breathe in a little more, but I'm using so much air talking, but I don't know. Some good old inhale, exhale exercises, you know. Yeah, I suppose that about covers this one. Got a house, gonna move into that soon. T2's been really fun. Really bummed out about Afghanistan, but I really hope that, you know, the resistance movement there that has been fluttering on and off, I really hope that the news that keeps getting, there's so much fake news coming out from the Indian government, the Pakistani government, I'm not sure what their system is, just a lot of false information coming out, and it's hard to really decipher in the West, you know, because I'm still trying to learn Arabic, but I know that Farsi or what do they call it? I think Persian is what they call their language as well. They use the same alphabet, you know, but whenever I try to translate things, it's really hard because, again, it's a different language, and most people in the West don't necessarily speak Farsi, so I don't know if that's going to become not want to say like a specialty of mine, but I don't know if I'm going to dive into maybe that area of the language family or what in the future, but I really want to get back to practicing Arabic more and doing more with that. Yeah, because I have a few, you know, fun things that I can say. You know, obviously, marhaban. My pronunciation's a little rough right now. It's been a minute. Marhaban is hello or hi, greetings, how are ya? Same thing in German. Hallo, guten Tag. Stuff like that. But then, one of the fun sentences, I unfortunately, I've been having to rely on Google Translate because, unlike German, I haven't necessarily looked as hard for the good free resources as I would have liked to have been because, again, this, you know, house hunting thing has been a huge fucking, energy and time just sucker. You know, it's taken all my time and energy, and now that I'm in the home stretch, if you don't appreciate that pun, fuck you, but if you don't, then whatever. But my realtor thought it was pretty funny, and he jokingly said you know, my coworker who My coworker didn't laugh at that pun. My realtor jokingly said, yeah, you guys should fire him. And I was like, you know, I don't know if I have that kind of power, but I'll see what I can do. But no, now that that's calmed down a lot, I'm going to try to, you know, start learning Arabic again and practicing, because I want to say I'm like 3/4 of the way with just being able to see the letters and being able to sound out words, you know, but a lot of the fine details of like the short vowel sounds, you know, the different accent marks and things like that, and some of the characters that are a little more difficult for us Westerners to pronounce, you know. I started trying to do the noise to, I think it's Rhein is how you pronounce it, maybe? I'm not entirely sure. It looks kind of like a cursive E in English, and I believe that the one is Ein and one is Rhein, and I believe that the one I'm trying to pronounce is the one with the dot over it. But yeah, all right, had to take a tiny little breather there. But yeah, so one of the fun sentences I learned when I was, or translated at least, I hope that it makes sense, was, I like tea. Because again, I do. I've been trying to cut out pop, and it's rough because, you know, when I go out and about, you know, pop and soda, whatever you want to call it, soda pop is everywhere. It's ubiquitous to Western culture at this point, and sugar is not great for us. Now, natural sugars are one thing, but processed sugars and stuff like that is not super ideal. So I've been drinking this tea. It's called yerba mate, and it is like super, super caffeinated tea. I think it's black tea. I'm not positive, but I don't really know much more about it than that. It kind of tastes, actually, it looks very green tea-y, but I'm not sure if it is a green tea, but It kind of tastes like shit, so I'm hoping that I can just, you know, deal with it and eventually learn to like it as an acquired taste. But for now, I'm just kind of suffering through it. And, you know, I've been drinking that at work instead of taking, you know, bottles of, like, Mountain Dew with me. And honestly, you know, that, like, 16 ounces of tea does more for me, keeping me awake and keeping me caffeinated than the pop has ever, you know. And then one day I would like to just not have to rely on caffeine, but, you know, that's like, I don't know, people can drink their coffee and be hooked on it, and that's fine, but I don't know, I'd like to get away from it one day, eventually. So, Ana Ahab Al-Shai, unless it's Ana Ahab, I'm not, See, that's one of the things. There's three letters that, there's like a J, H, and a H, or like, yeah, I don't even know if the mic picked those up, but, Ana Ahab Al-Shai, or Ana Ahab, or Ana Ahab, I feel like I just did the same thing, but, hopefully that is a translation of Ishmag Te, or I like tea, you know, so yeah. A little bit of fun language learning here. Oh, man, I wish I still remembered how to say I'm learning Arabic. I know it's Arabia and blank Al-Arabia. But it's eluding me for now, so I'm going to hopefully get back into that. Yeah, I might be able to, I don't know. I mean, I kind of want to start listening to more German music again, you know, getting back into that too, because either earlier this year or late last year, Rammstein, I think, put out what's going to be their last album. I don't think they're going to do anything else after this, but those guys really helped me when I was first starting out in German and learning it, and I just love their music. You know, it's hard to get sometimes as a Westerner, but at times, I don't know, they're also one of those weird bands that, like, people in Germany don't really like them, but the rest of the world loves them, and I don't necessarily get that. I mean, I'm sure that there are a lot of American bands that, like, people, you know, overseas love that we just do not love or hate even, but, you know. So if anybody is ever interested, I would love to do, if I could, as much of a podcast in German as I could in the future. You know, if anybody in Germany, Austria, Switzerland, disclaimer here, I don't speak Switzerdeutsch, so... Anybody in der Schweiz, unfortunately we can't do that, but I love my voice cracks, but yeah, I would love to do a podcast in German and try to do as much, or like try to have a conversation even, you know, and talk about things. And I know that so much is just borrowed from English nowadays, but I haven't gotten enough practice in the last few years, and unfortunately all my friends, they don't get to come over as much as they would like. You know, everybody I met back in like high school that was transfer students, or exchange students rather, and then with the Rona hitting, things have been kind of weird for as far as travel. I just saw that France is going to ban unvaccinated Americans, and I'm like, okay, I don't know what their plans are for refugees that are coming in that are unvaccinated, but I'm sure that that's not relevant to the discussion. But anyways, episode, I think I already forgot, 18? No, if I open up my, if I open up Brave, then my computer freaks the fuck out. Tells me I'm over loading everything. Yeah, episode 18, something something, episode 6. I think that's all I've got. I'm going to come back after the outro song for my good old normal outro. But this is Santana featuring Chad Kroeger from Nickelback, Into the Night. I hope you enjoy it. A good one.
Like a gift from the heavens, it was easy to tell. It was love from above that could save me from hell. She had fire in her soul, it was easy to see how the devil himself could be pulled out of me. There were drums in the air as she started to dance. Soul in the room, keeping time with their hands, and we sang hey-oh-hey-oh-hey-oh-hey, and a voice in us rang like the angels sing, and singing hey-oh-hey-oh-hey-oh-hey, and we danced on into the night, and we danced on into the night, piece to the puzzle that falls into place. Tell how we felt from the look on our faces. We were spinning in circles with the moon in our eyes. No room left to move in between you and I. We forgot where we were and we lost track of time. And we sang to the wind as we danced through the night. And we sang. Danced on.
happens, it was easy to tell. It was love from above that could save me from hell. She had fire in her soul, it was easy to see how the devil himself could be pulled out of me. There were drums in the air as she started to dance, every soul in the room keeping time with their hands. And we sang, hey, away, 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 and the voices rang like the angels sing.
Yeah, that is just a fantastic song. Like I said, it's a pretty upbeat song. That is pretty pretty cool. I don't know. I'm kind of having trouble finding the words here to describe what I want to say in the end. But yeah. Haven't gotten the chance to update their website for a little while, so I might work on that maybe sometime here soon. Episode 17, Inspiration, should be out by the time this comes out. Go ahead and check that out. Episode 16, Change in Adaptation. I might do another episode kind of about transitions, which, you know, is a kind of... It's almost very similar to adaptation, but at the same time, I don't know, I feel like we live a lot of our lives in transition between, you know, one thing and another, so that might be, you know, a good topic, and if anybody wants to write me to talk about that, you know, I'm more than willing. The email address is darth@stsbedcast.com, sorry. We still have the Gmail addresses, somebedcast@gmail.com, somethingsomethingbedcast@gmail.com, if anybody's interested. Those didn't go away. It's just now that I'm hosting my own website and hosting my own email, well, technically they're being hosted by someone else, but I'm paying to have them hosted, you know, legitimately now. Then I'd like to use those since, again, you know, they're there for a reason. But, yeah, I'm going to try to update the website, kind of get some more useful type information there. I might start trying to get some articles actually put up and just kind of, they're going to be, you know, if I actually use any sources or factual stuff, then I'm going to try to list my resources and all that and list links to different things. But they'll you know, be adjacent in subject matter and theme to the stuff I talk about here. And, yeah. So I'm going to do my normal outro, but something that I heard today, my mom, there's an old saying, you know, somebody, we were leaving the restaurant and someone said, you know, be safe. And then the other person was like, yeah, yeah. And so my mom, she brought up this old saying that says, you know, if you can't be safe, at least be careful. And I kind of want to impart that to everyone. You know, we all take certain risks every day. We partake in certain dangers, some people more than others. And, you know, there's a lot to be said about that in certain regards and certain aspects of things. But if you can't be, you know, safe, just be careful. You know what risks you're indulging in. Know what you can and can't handle. And just be careful out there. Other than that, I think that's all I've got. Next episode, episode 19, might be another something-something, might be transitions, I don't know. Certainly gonna talk just more random, more free-flowing stuff. You know, this episode didn't really cover too many topics, but, you know, it was more loose, I feel like, than me talking about trying to stay at least on a single topic. So yeah, I think that's all I've got this week. Go forth and be excellent. spread your excellence, and be the change you want to see. And then in parentheses, in the world. I feel like I might have to start putting that and saying that, but for now, it's pretty much where it is. Excuse me. Yeah. Oh, I forgot, you know. I forgot that I've been adding to it. Go forth and be excellent. Spread your excellence and be the change you want to see. And shine on, you crazy diamonds. Because everyone out there, you are all beautiful just the way you are. Everyone has things they want to change about themselves and potentially a few things that they can. But, you know, everyone's trying their best. They're trying their hardest to work through things. And that's, in the end, that's all that matters. So shine on, you crazy diamonds. I love you all. Until next time. Bye.